The budget process is underway, but what does it mean for environmental programs? I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Greg Vitali. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for hosting, Jill.
The governor proposed his budget in February. The Senate has put forward their version of the budget. Let's talk a little bit about where we stand in terms of funding for environmental programs. The Senate restored some of the funding that was taken out for environmental programs in the governor's proposed budget. But where do we stand right now?
Yeah, they just kicked out the budget. The House on May 9th, the House will be considering that probably the week of June 4th before that will go through an amendment process. The Senate's budget was, Corbett's budget was very lean, a $27.1 billion proposal. The Senate put back $500 million to that. So it helped a little bit, but it's still a very bad budget and it doesn't take into account available revenue sources. The environment still got hit pretty hard, too hard. One of the big problems of the Corbett budget was they were going to take money from the Keystone Fund, which really helped things like state park and forest infrastructure, open spaces, and so forth. Very popular program.
Which now, the Senate did restore some of that funding.
Half of
in
it.
Their
so instead of putting $38.5 million, they just cut half of that back. But other environmental programs that weren't restored so far are the Farmland Preservation Program. Preserves a lot of farmland and scenic scapes in Pennsylvania. The governor drained all $20 million from that. Rather, it took the tax that was going to fund that and put it into the general fund. They're going to backfill that with some other environmental money for 2 years, but then it's gone. They also zeroed out something called the AFIG program, the Alternative Fuels Incentive Grant Program. The governor's budget did that. That's $6 million. The Senate kept that just as it was. That's the type program that incents things like the charging stations you may use if you buy a Volt or one of the other electric cars. It also incents things like biofuels and so forth. So in this age where we're struggling to be energy independent, we want to be encouraging things like alternative fuel vehicles, so zeroing that out is a problem. So overall, they're also taking $10 million in funding for the DEP, the Department of Environmental Protection personnel. This supplies boots on the ground from the Department of Environmental Protection to make sure all our environmental laws are enforced. The governor took another $10 million and the Senate has kept that. So we have to really get as much of that back into the budget as the weeks and months progress. We have to get this budget done by the end of June. So time to militate environmental forces.
Now let's talk a little bit about potential alternative funding, because obviously still a challenging budget year, mm-hmm. as the last several years have been in this down economy. You have said that you would not be in favor of cuts to business taxes that the Senate has put forward in their proposed budget.
Right. This budget reduces business taxes by another $275 million. I think that should be frozen, not the time to do that. There are other revenue sources. One thing we ought to be doing is increasing the air permitting fees to fund the Department of Environmental Protection air program. A permitting fee increase package was in the works under the Rendell administration, but stopped under Corbett.
Who pays those fees?
The people who want to pollute the air. Businesses, not only gas drillers, but anyone else who wants the permission to put pollutants into the air. It's considered fair that the people putting pollutants into the air ought to pay for the program that has to enforce it and make sure the laws are being enforced. So that's a source. Ending something called the vendor discount, taxing cigars and smokeless tobacco, closing the Delaware loophole. There's a lot of revenue sources out there that really aren't being tapped, not for good policy reasons, but because of maybe protected special interest. And we have to sort of get all those sources of revenue to help us properly fund the environment and other things.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Greg Vitali. I'm Jill Horner.